Your Eminence, Metropolitan Methodios, it's an honor and a blessing for all of us that you are here today with us with your fatherly love. Please bless us. Dear brothers and sisters, today we celebrate Anthony the Great. In my mind, always I see Anthony the Great parallel to the young man who comes to Christ and asks him what to do to inherit the kingdom of God. The Lord answers him, says, go sell everything, give to the poor, get treasures in heaven, and come follow me. Unfortunately, the young man leaves the Lord in deep sadness because he had too many attachments to his possessions. And however, the Lord was not too sad, because in his divine sight he could see that perhaps one day this young man will figure out his life, will cut his attachments to the world, he will get rid of his anxieties and find the way back to the Lord. And today another young man, Anthony the Great, enters into the church and hears the same exact words, and he responds differently. He goes and does exactly what the Lord asks him to do. Sell everything, give to the poor, and come follow me. In today's gospel, we see that people respond to the same call different ways also. We have 10 lepers who come to the Lord and ask him to cleanse them. And only one of them, after being cleansed, comes and thanks the Lord. I hope and I pray that we respond to the call of the Lord like Anthony the Great, not like the young man delaying his salvation, and like this one leper who above all puts the thankfulness in his life, not to receive continuously, but to give thanks for the things that he had received. I hope that both the young man and the 9 lepers will find their way to the Lord, because he is the way and he is the life. And as we see in the example of Anthony the Great, when we respond to the call of the Lord in a proper way, then he takes us who are made from clay, and he turns us into the diamond of the desert, like he did with Anthony. Today the question for us is, what is our response to the Lord? And I hope that all of us will find our way to the Lord, because we all need his blessings. And like that one leper, we need to hear, your faith has made you well. Go in peace, now and forever. Amen.
Καλημέρα σε όλους, καλή χρονιά εύχομαι. Το 2021 να είναι ευλογημένο με υγεία, με χαρά και με κάθε ουράνιο αγαθό για όλα τα μέλη της ιστορικής αυτής κοινότητας και για όλον τον κόσμο. 10 λεπροί σήμερα πλησίασαν τον Χριστό στην Ευαγγελική περικοπή, και ο Χριστός τους θεράπευσε. Τους θεράπευσε διότι υπήκουσαν στην εντολή Του. Και ποια ήταν η εντολή αυτή? Πηγαίνετε στους ιερείς και θα καθαριστείτε. Μας λέει ο Ευαγγελιστής ότι μόνον ένας γύρισε να ευχαριστήσει το Θεό. Και όταν τον είδε ο Χριστός, αυτόν τον Σαμαρίτη, λέει, η δε νέα πού? Δεν καθάρισα 10, μόνον ο Σαμαρίτης ήρθε να μου πει ένα ευχαριστώ. Και στη σημερινή εκκλησία υπάρχουν πολλοί λεπροί. Όλοι μας είμαστε λεπροί. Όλοι μας κάτι έχουμε. Μπορεί να μην έχουμε τη λέπρα του σώματος, αλλά έχουμε τη λέπρα της ψυχής. Διότι όλοι μας στη ζωή μας έχουμε δείξει σημεία αχαριστίας. Ο Χριστός μας έχει ευεργετήσει με ζωή, με υγεία, με οικογένειες, με παιδιά, με φίλους. Αλλά εμείς πολλές φορές είμαστε αχάριστοι για την ευεργεσία, τις ευεργεσίες αυτές. Και μάλιστα ζηλεύουμε τους μη Ορθοδόξους, οι οποίοι έγιναν Ορθόδοξοι Χριστιανοί. Ζηλεύουμε τους σημερινούς Σαμαρίτες, τους προσιλήτους, και τους θεωρούμε αυτούς λεπρούς και δεν έχουμε καμία επαφή με αυτούς. Ήρθε σήμερα επίσης να ευχαριστήσω και να συγχαρώ τον προϊστάμενό σας, τον πατέρα Αντώνη, ο οποίος από τη στιγμή που ήρθε στην κοινότητα αυτή έχει αγκαλιάσει όλο το εκκλησίασμα, αγαπήθηκε από όλους, διότι είναι ένας σεμνός κληρικός ο οποίος αγαπά το Θεό και αγαπιέται από τον Θεό.
Father Anthony, I want to thank you publicly for the ministry that you are offering this community. I am thankful to God that He sent you to this metropolis and that I was able to assign you to this parish some time ago. It's a joy for me to hear from people in the parish wherever I go. And I see people from Somerville, they tell me how blessed they are that you are their priest, how dedicated you are, and how much they love and embrace you. And that is to your credit. And I pray that you serve them for years with health and joy, that you always have your embrace open for everyone, that you go to their homes and visit them in their homes, that you bless those homes and their places of business, and that God continue to grace and honor your priesthood here. And I want to thank the congregation for embracing Father Anthony from the moment that he came to this parish. I think you realized from the very beginning that he was a devout man of God, a family man, a churchman, and someone whose vision is clear about where this church should go in this country. God bless you all with a year filled with health, joy, and every heavenly gift. Chronia Pola.
Thank you very much.